I was also surprised that Al went out so quick. Within like 10 seconds, Al, you're out.
I'm gonna offer you a bribe. You take $50,000 if you walk out of the game tonight.
That's guaranteed cash, Olivia.
You're gonna take the money?
Yeah.
It really is a completely new game right now. Everything that we've known is out the window. Everything that we've thought is gone.
Thank you for not liking me. See you guys.
Bye, Olivia.
I didn't think there was any chance in hell that she was gonna take it. I thought she was a mole.
A group of strangers working together to earn up to $1 million. That in the end, only one of them will win. One of these players is the mole, a double agent we hired working for us against the other 13. At the end of each episode, the players take the quiz, 10 questions about the mole. The quiz determines who stays and who goes because the player who scores the lowest on the quiz is executed and is sent home immediately. Up to $1 million hinges on discovering who is the mole.
Boy, oh boy. I'm never forming another coalition again. Not that I have many choices left, but
first time in my life, I'm at a loss for words.
Boy, you guys are diabolical. I am telling you.
Blows my freaking mind. Absolutely floors my ass, knocks me on the ground.
This game is now going to become one of backstabbing and shrewd play. Every exemption is like gold. Kids, if you're watching me at home, be aware. Dad may have to do some things that aren't going to be too nice.
Watch for the hidden clue to the identity of the mole. With seven players executed, the remaining seven head to lunch at a local trattoria, where they will find a valuable clue to the next game.
What is missing in this picture? The glove of the mole.
Seven people holding newspapers up over their face, and underneath it said, "With love, the mole." And immediately the idea is, has the mole ever said, "With love"?
Yeah.
Their faces are missing.
If they discover the meaning of the clue, it could help them win this next valuable game.
Well, today you're all playing for something very valuable. Heather, your boyfriend Nathan, is here to see you. Al, your sister Janine. Darwin, your wife Lindsay. Bill, your brother-in-law Blair is here. Dorothy, your mom Kathy. Ribs, your mom, Terry, is here, and Katie, your dad, Ron, are all here to see you. If you do well in this next game, you will earn the right to see your loved one for one night. I'll also throw in some money. For each successful player, $5,000 will be added to the pot. If you're all successful, you'll all be happy, and you'll earn $35,000 for the pot. I do want to warn you, if you are not successful in this game, you will not see your loved one. Katie, we'll begin with you. Please follow me. The rest of you stay here. So, this game is a test of observation and communication skills. How well you do will depend on how well you can describe your loved one to someone else, all right? Okay. You have to pick someone to be your eyes. Then that person will have 2 minutes to try to pick out your loved one from a crowded piazza or the town square from the second story window. If, however, your eyes does not successfully pick out your loved one, you don't earn the money and you do not get to spend the night with your loved one, all right?
I choose Heather.
Fine, we'll get Heather up here.
I feel since day one, she has been the one person I can trust. I don't know why the game would change now. I mean, it could, and again, that could kick me in the butt. Who knows?
Hey, Heather, come on in. So here's how this game works. You have been selected to be her eyes. You will have 2 minutes to look at the square and to try to select Ron from the second story window. Do not successfully pick out Katie's dad, you don't earn the money, and Katie does not get to see her father. Katie will have 30 seconds to describe her father to you. The 30 seconds starts now.
Okay, he's 68 and he's kind of balding, but he might have a hat on and he wears it kind of crooked. And he's kind of fat, like pregnant belly fat. And he's like 5'8", probably a big smile. If he's talking, he's talking with his hands just like me. We look an awful lot alike. He's got a bigger nose, grayish blonde hair, kind of a bald spot. You'll know him. He looks just like me.
Stop. Okay, your 2 minutes begins now.
And I can't even see. I need my glasses for this. I can't see long distances. I knew that Heather wore glasses. I thought they were for reading. I didn't realize what she was going to be looking into, how far she had to look. I didn't take that into account. I just knew that I trusted Heather, and in picking her, I knew she would try her hardest to find my father.
It's not that I can't see long distance. Glasses makes things a lot sharper for me, and I sort of squint and have a hard time seeing long distance, so.
You have 40 more seconds.
There's some man sitting at that table with a baseball cap on. Okay, there's also somebody with a purple baseball cap on right there.
You have 15 seconds left. And time. Can you turn away?
I'm out. Say the guy in the blue shirt. I don't know. Sunglasses in the belly. In my heart of hearts, I just hope it could be him walking around the corner. No.
Sorry.
Of course, I was full-blown upset. I felt very threatened that maybe I suckered myself into a coalition with maybe the mole.
Not only does Katie miss out on her reunion with her father...
Thank you.
Heather's mistake cost the team $5,000.
Who would you like to be your eyes?
Heather.
We'll bring in Heather.
Okay. I pick Heather for my eyes because I think that she would be able to identify my mom the best. And recalling our time in Switzerland, I vaguely recalled showing her a picture of my family, including my mother.
Miss your mom?
Yeah. And she's probably excited right now. She's got my height, it's 5'2.5", 5'3". Shoulder length, black hair, probably wavy or curly down here. She's probably wearing a long dress. Probably the only Asian person in the nearby vicinity. I doubt that.
You have 2 minutes, starting now.
I mean, I only see one Asian person. She has short hair, she looks young, right there. It looks like somebody might be sitting at the table over there, but I can't really tell. Given the fact that she said, oh, there can't be that many Asian people out there, she didn't fully describe her. There's a lady in like a green vest back there. And I can't even tell.
And time. I need your selection.
Jeez.
Who do you think it is?
I don't know. I'd have to say the girl, the lady in the green. Not my mom.
It's not your mom. I think that one is Italian.
Yeah, I think so too. I don't recall seeing a picture of Dorothy's mom. I don't remember it at all. I guess that's why she picked me though, and so I feel really bad. I think Heather is playing the naive card a little too much, and that's always suspicious in a game like this. You know what I figured out? These are our pants in the picture. Like, that's my dad. I bought him that shirt. This is a Keen Pumpkin Festival.
I wonder which one
As Dorothy and Katie figure out the meaning of the clue, they realize they will both be a solo act tonight.
This sucks. I wonder what we'll be doing tonight.
I think it was helpful to know that I wasn't the only one that doesn't have a loved one that they don't get to see.
Who do you want to select to be your aunt?
Darwin.
Okay. Bring up Darwin?
The only reservation that I had was the fact that he wears contacts.
You said you're more nervous about this?
Yeah.
Why?
Why? Because it's more valuable than a whole lot of money, as far as I'm concerned.
Seeing your mom?
Sure. She's about 5'7", 5'8", obviously a white woman. She has brown, gray, kind of peppered hair. She usually will wear glasses. She might be wearing some bright colors.
I think I know what it is. I think she's sitting right there on the stairs next to the gentleman with the dark sunglasses. Well, that could be her, too.
45 seconds.
Oh, God. She wears glasses. That woman has glasses. That woman has sunglasses. I gotta go with her.
Lady. Were you afraid it wouldn't work out?
Just a teeny bit.
I'm happy for them, but I'm crying for myself.
Yeah, me too.
Are they feeding you and sleeping you?
It's Italy. How could you not be eating it?
I know.
Keep in mind, though, that I don't know if everybody has been able to see their loved one yet.
I
don't know about those two behind you.
Which one?
Come here, puppy. Doggy. What's that?
Ooh, we vomitist.
That was so gross.
He leaned over and...
I thought it was his tongue. I'm like, why is he licking the ground? And then it looks so gross.
Why is the tongue...
No, no, that's so gross. At least we got to laugh about something.
I'm so sorry, guys.
Can I give you a hug from whoever was here?
That was the nerve-wracking thing. The thought that we might actually be here and... not be able to see our people.
I'm just a person now. I'm just a people.
A loved one. I'm the loved one. You're the player.
You don't love
Get
me.
Get the lingo.
All right.
Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
It's not my brother-in-law. He kisses me. I'm going to thump you. If it is my brother-in-law, he kisses me. I'm going to thump you.
To see their loved ones. Now, it's Bill's turn.
My brother-in-law is black-headed, 48 years old, hair a little longer than mine, black with salt, pepper, gray. The distinguishing feature, though, is he's got a nice-sized handlebar mustache.
Okay, this gentleman with salt and pepper hair with what looks like a large mustache. I can't really tell if it's a handlebar mustache. He looks like he weighs about 180, big arms. Hat, sunglasses, he has a mustache, but it doesn't look like a handlebar mustache.
One minute remaining.
The guy kind of underneath the umbrella and the yellow shirt, but I can't see him. He doesn't look that tall anyway. Yeah, I'm gonna go with the gentleman in the blue.
It's not my brother-in-law. He kisses me. I'm gonna thump you. If it is my brother-in-law, he kisses me. I'm gonna thump you. Yeah.
Is that it?
Little bud, yeah. I've never seen that guy before in my life. Take him back to jail.
How you doing?
Good, good.
What a surprise.
Yeah, it is a surprise.
You couldn't be any more surprised than I was a couple days ago when I found out where I was going.
That's got to be the brother-in-law.
It's not Bill's wife, Shirley, but a happy reunion nonetheless.
Oh, it was emotional. Where the hell is Shirley? Why did she come?
She can't find her passport. She was disappointed.
Well, I can imagine she was disappointed. Well, me too. It was a shock to me, I've got to tell you. When Anderson announced your loved one, and I'm ready for him to say, Shirley, your brother-in-law, Blair. That's brother-in-law, Blair. In the first place, he's only my liked one, not my loved one. And the second place, I was really distraught that my wife wasn't here until I found out the circumstances. I'm still distraught, but that's okay.
It's my lucky day.
It's now Brib's turn to search for Al's loved one. His sister, Janine, came because Al's wife couldn't make the trip.
Al, your 30 seconds begins now.
Hair is like a sandy brown, usually right about here. Big smile, thin eyebrows. Looks like me, has a face like me. If she's talking, she's louder than I am.
They're all turning to the side. This woman right here fits the description. I wish I could see her eyes. I'm gonna have to say the girl looking straight ahead.
How do you think Brooks did?
Nah, he didn't nail it.
You don't think?
No. Nope.
No? So it obviously means you do not get the $5,000 from Pod and will not be able to see your sister.
Yep.
Sorry.
That was the one you picked out, Brib?
I know what your sister looks like, and nobody was facing.
It could have been a fun time.
Obviously, this isn't something that anybody would try to screw over it.
I don't think it's worth it.
It was the sincerity from Brib's when he didn't pick Janine.
Yeah,
I think to some degree there was. I think that he would have been as equally upset if he hadn't seen his loved one. It's hard to tell because you didn't really get to see what was going on.
Even if you were at a mall, I think he'd screw this one. You know how.
Hey, sweat. No worries.
No worries, bro.
My wife is about 5'3", 5'4". She has naturally blonde hair, definitely fair skin. She wears solids.
There's a woman right there, you know, she's wearing black pants and solids. It looks like she might have naturally blonde hair and it might have been a little bit darker. I think that's too blonde. The one in the orange. I'm gonna go ahead and to say the one there with the handbag.
Good luck.
Thanks. That's her.
Hey. It is, it is.
I get happy for other people. Are you having fun?
Yeah, it's fun and then stress and then fun and then pain and then fun and then
Heather has failed two of her fellow players by not locating their loved ones. Her fate now lies in the hands of one of her teammates. She chooses Brib's to locate her boyfriend, Nathan.
Brib's and I have had really long talks about Nathan and his ex-girlfriend and relationships, and I think I've showed the picture to him several times, and I just feel most confident in Brib's.
Brib's? I think second on my suspect list. She told me yesterday, I want you to stick around till the end. So I'm telling you, don't vote for me.
Coming up on The Mole, The Next Betrayal.
Katie, of course, cried copious tears.
Don't cry.
Al was angry. He may have just walked around the corner anyway and said, to hell with it, I'm out of here.
Chosen to be the eyes for two other players, Brib's lost once and won once. Now it's up to him to find Heather's boyfriend, Nathan, in the piazza below.
He's about 5'11", my color hair, his ears kind of stick out like this a little bit. He's got piercing blue eyes, full lips.
Your 2 minutes begins now.
I don't want to screw this up for him. Guy down there on the left, blue shirt. Yeah, black hair. He's well built.
Seem pretty confident?
Pretty confident. Guy in the yellow way over there with the sunglasses on. Kind of resembles him. He looks kind of nervous. Yeah. Looks like he might have piercing blue eyes.
Not just blue, they're piercing.
They're piercing, yeah. But he's totally making out with this girl. I don't understand. It couldn't be him. Yeah, let's go ahead and just pick him.
All right.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
key to my eye.
It's been the hardest thing. It's been so stressful, and I haven't been able to talk to anybody.
They're so cute.
Nathan, pleasure to meet you.
Darwin, Nathan, I already know you. Before I even walked up to the window, I was like, that's your Dallas, Texas boy right there. Yeah. Good stuff.
All right, well, congratulations, four of you. We're reunited with your loved ones. I'm very happy to see that. It's nice to see so many smiling faces finally. Also, because four of you were reunited, each of you earned $5,000 for the pot, so the pot goes up by $20,000 and now stands at $286,000. So, a nice job. Katie, Dorothy, Al, I am really sorry you were not reunited with your loved ones. I'm really sorry.
Dorothy evinced very little emotion. Katie, of course, cried copious tears, which is sort of a normal state of affairs for Katie.
Don't cry. Try not to.
Al was angry.
I feel bad that she's here, and I just get to talk to her and say, hey.
If that had been his wife back there instead of his sister, he may have just walked around the corner anyway and said, to hell with it, I'm out of here. I'm going to go see my wife.
Later that evening, Nathan and Heather take a little romantic detour, Italian style.
I don't want you to leave.
This is the most romantic dinner we've ever had.
Sort of.
I brought you something, a little. Okay. Nothing to say. Okay? I never imagined. Listen, I want you to hear this. I never imagined in my entire life that I could ever love someone as much as I love you. And I'm totally in love with you. And please spend the rest of your life with me and marry me. Will you? Okay. It's a little bigger than we thought.
Oh my God.
You like it? Think about the perfect woman for me, and it's Heather. I can't imagine adding anything to her. She's the total package. When you're in love, you know that's the one, and I know.
The players and their loved ones have been separated again. But it's a new day and a new game. For those who were unable to visit with their loved ones yesterday, they now have a second chance.
I should just point out your loved ones are all over there. Katie, your dad is there. Al, your sister. Dorothy, your mom is there. Today's game is worth a total of $70,000 for the pot. So there's a lot of money at stake, and you'll be able to spend today and tomorrow with your loved ones. This game tests how well you really know each other. We asked your loved ones a simple question about you. The question was, will you bungee jump? First, each of you has to guess what your loved one predicted. If your action matches their prediction, you win the game, you earn $10,000 for the pot, and more importantly, you get to spend the rest of today and tomorrow with your loved ones. Heather, we'll start with you. Please follow me.
My mom is afraid of heights, and she knows I'm not, but I think she would think that I would not jump.
You don't think she thinks she would jump, then you shouldn't do it. Okay. But you have to match whatever she's doing.
Yeah.
What do you think Nathan predicted?
I think he definitely said that I would.
What are you going to do?
I'll jump. I worry that she would think that I would be willing to do it simply because of where I am.
Only you know your mom, you know?
Well, they say 170 feet.
Oh, thanks.
She holds on to that ring.
Go, Heather!
She's shaking.
Oh, that's frightening.
It's really high.
Just fall backwards?
Perfect. 3, 2, 1, go!
Oh my God. Oh my God.
No?
No, at all.
I don't think I could have done that.
Let's see what Nathan said. Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
So if the bungee broke, would the impact kill you?
Yes.
Okay, that's good to know.
Go!
A quick and painless death?
Heather just plunged from 170 feet in an attempt to win another visit with her fiancé, Nathan. Now she finds out if her prediction is correct.
Definitely, I think Heather will jump.
I knew it.
All right, $10,000 and you've seen it.
Yes. Oh, my God, it was miserable. Are you ready, Darwin?
Yep. 3, 2, 1, go!
I have no question in my mind that Darwin will jump. Absolutely. Anything to win. I thought maybe you didn't want to spend 4 days.
We said I'd like to do it, but I never thought I'd have the courage to do that. Nah. That and jump out of a plane, a couple things, you know.
Unlike Heather and Darwin, Al has not had the chance to spend time with his sister, Janine. If he guesses incorrectly, Janine will leave Italy without them being reunited.
Oh, boy.
Give me an A.
Three, two, one, go! Oh my God! Why am I spinning so much?
So, Gene, do you think your brother Al will jump?
I think that Al will absolutely jump.
I was like, you gotta know.
I knew you were doing it. I was like, there's no way he's not gonna jump. I was also threatening to pick you up if you didn't jump. King Al, it strikes again. When we were kids, Al was the king of the family. He's the only boy. It was so bad that we would be like, yeah, you're not gonna get choked because you're the king. And Al would say, that's right, I'm the king. I'm the king of the family.
Don't you forget it.
Yeah.
Well, you won't.
Now the country will know about
the king.
The
country will know that Al believes he's the king. Is it possible for the bungee, like, to boing right back up and hit that thingy? No.
I gotta tell you, I do feel like I'm an older generation right now.
Tell me when. About far enough or not?
I've always wanted a bungee jump. I don't guess I've ever really quite worked up the nerve to actually go do it.
3, 2, 1, go!
Given the fact that there's money involved, I think he'll jump. If he won't, I'll be happy to push him on behalf of my sister.
It's great.
This is a great place here. Gorgeous city.
So if the bungee broke, would the impact kill you?
Yes.
Okay, that's good to know. A quick and painless death?
Go!
Oh, man. Oh, my gosh.
Think Bruce will jump?
Bruce will jump. The minute he sees the setup, he'll be thrilled.
Yeah!
All right, so far, $50,000 earned for the pot, 5 reunions. Dorothy, you're next.
Dorothy and Katie are the only two players left who have not been reunited with their loved ones.
Yeah, man, she's so scared of her. What do you think your mom predicted?
I think my mom predicted no.
She would say you did not jump?
Yes.
You would not jump?
I would not jump.
And what are you going to do?
I am not going to jump.
All right, so we're not jumping.
Oh. See, I'm going based on, you know, under normal circumstances, I think she would say no immediately. And there's always the thought, oh, well, would she do it just because I'm here? I'm just going with the original.
Do you think Dorothy will jump?
Yeah, I think Dorothy will jump.
Oh.
Why? You have to try.
Sorry. So, we are actually going to give you 5 minutes to see her.
Oh.
Oh.
I love. Think I would want bungee jumps. And sorry to the rest of the players. Yes, I know I'm an idiot. I screw up even the easiest games.
Katie is the last to jump. If she guesses correctly, she'll be reunited with her father and add another $10,000 to the pot.
Oh, God, I'm scared right now. I'm afraid of heights. I don't know if I can do this.
She's gonna do it. She's gonna do it.
She'll be crying. But she'll be going.
Probably. Probably.
Just a matter of concentration?
Mm-hmm. What do I concentrate on?
Yourself.
On myself?
Yeah.
Okay. I've been through a lot in my life. I can get through this. I can get through this. Okay. Wait, can I have a minute? Okay.
Don't think about it. Just
okay.
Four,
right now?
Four, three, two, one, go!
I scream really loud?
Perfect.
Okay. That's just the most amazing thing I've ever done, I think. Wow.
And he kept yelling,
oh, my God, oh, my God. I hope my dad said yes. I really think he did.
I know she thinks her mother would kill her if she tried something like this, but as her old man, I think she's going to do it. I really have a lot of faith in the young lady. She's going to do it.
Great.
Can I go?
Dad.
Thank you for having me. I've learned that I should have more faith in myself. I should have been more confident from the get-go that I would do well in this game.
I know you'd do it.
She's acting more like a young lady than my little baby. She's our baby, you know. She's our youngest.
You guys did a great job. You earned $60,000 for the pot. The pot now stands at $346,000. You broke the $300,000 mark. Dorothy, I'm sorry you don't get to spend tonight and tomorrow with your mom. Most of you were reunited. I'm really happy about that. All right?
Cool.
So, let's... on to the next event.
On to the next event, yeah.
Having Janine here, it makes me feel better about the game because I was getting to a point where the strain of being away from the ones I care so much about was starting to weigh on me a little bit. You start thinking more and more about home, especially, you know, you get further in the game and all the stress of that, and it's like, I just don't even need to be here. I need to be home. And it reminds me that there is a home life, you know, and she coming here, it puts me at ease again. It's like another jump start.
I was definitely really disappointed not to be able to see my mom, but, you know, I think it was interesting for me to be able to observe other people interacting with the people that they're probably most natural around.
I definitely think that Albert could be the mole. Definitely think Al could be the mole.
Oh, you could be the mole. You could definitely be the mole.
I don't think that John would be the mole.
Katie's not the mole. Katie's not the mole.
Thanks a lot.
I'm obviously not the mole because I idiotically screw up every single game. Not the mole.
I don't think you're the mole. I don't think they'd choose you for the mole simply because of the fact that you're the obvious choice.
I'm not surprised Heather's still in the game in any way because if she was the mole, first of all, I think that'd be a great choice for her because she's brilliant and she's very conniving. I think she'd be excellent as the mole.
Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
It is time now to face your eighth execution.
It is time once again for the quiz. 10 questions about the mole. Question number one. According to the mole, what is their best quality?
I think Bill could be the mole for the reason that he's very quiet. He doesn't offer very much. He's always kind of sitting on the outskirts and observing.
Number two, How many times did the mole incorrectly identify someone's loved one in relative disguise?
I don't know.
The person she selected will be coming around that corner.
Not my mom.
The mole has got to make mistakes. That's the nature of the mole. That's the nature of the game. I can't ignore Heather. I just cannot rule her out, and she wears the devil out of me.
Number three. In the last two games, how many times was the mole successful in earning the opportunity to see their loved one? Number four. What color shirt or top was the mole's loved one wearing when selected during relative disguise?
I'm going to say the guy in the blue shirt, but I don't know.
Number five. What relationship is the mole's loved one to them?
I think Bruce could be the mole as well. He is very much the player. He has mentioned numerous times, oh, I'm so naive. I don't know, they're just fishy to me.
I'm not a naive person. I'm an intelligent person. I know the world, but playing this game, I'm naive.
Number six. In what position did the mole choose their eyes in relative disguise? Number seven. Did the mole jump during relative bungee yesterday?
That one was a little curious, because Dorothy was the only one who didn't get to see her mom. But what a great idea to, like, sacrifice that, knowing you'll see them on the back end. So it makes, like, looks like you took a personal hit, but at the same time, you took a hit from the pod. I mean, that would be a nice, smooth move.
Number eight, did the mole receive a new journal yesterday?
We have a new journal for you.
Oh, yes!
And is there anyone else who feels they're running out of journals
with? Number nine. According to what the mole said at dinner tonight, how long has the mole been together with their significant other? Number 10, who is the mole?
The pot now stands at $346,000. So it's above the $300,000 mark. You all are putting a lot of money away. Tonight, we do have a tie. So tonight, the player who was executed is the player who not only answered the most questions wrong on the quiz, they are also the player who took the longest to answer those questions. All right, let's begin. Bill. I should point out there are three players remaining: Al, Katie, Heather. Al.
See Katie go. I know she really wanted to make it to the ninth round, and I wish that she could have just made it that one more round.
I'm sad that I have to go, but
but I had an awesome time. I mean, I bungee jumped yesterday. I mean, that's the biggest thing. And my dad's here with me, so, I mean, I can't complain at all. I never thought I would make it this far.
I think the whole jelly thing with Katie, in combination with the Meadow Muffin moments, she's so funny. She always reacted to things so strongly. And she definitely provided a lot of entertainment and a lot of laughs for us.
I'll definitely miss Katie. She kind of just took flack from me. Sometimes I can be kind of mean when I'm joking around with somebody. She took it and she started giving it back these past few weeks.
Oh yeah, it was really tough. Especially within the last couple of weeks, it's been really tough.
That's crap.
Did you guys get offered an exemption?
Crap.
I could see that the stress of the game was starting to get to her. And the more stress that she was under, the quirkier she became. The quirkier she became, the more stress I was under. I needed to alleviate that pressure. And, no, it's... Yeah, she's a great gal, but, yeah, no, good luck, Katie.
What a disaster I am.
Well, it was really great meeting you.
It was a pleasure meeting you, too. Thank you. You, too. I'll send you a picture of my
right.
Muffin.
It's great to meet you. Take care.
One of my favorite moments of Katie is actually the gladiator game. It's so awesome to see her get in there and take a whack at those gladiators and emerge victorious. She's so proud of herself. It was awesome to see her confident and happy about her performance.
Oh my god! Did I scream really loud? I can't believe I just did that. I'm happy I've made it this far. I'm so proud of myself. I never thought I would do this, get here, be here. Wow, this is amazing.
Take care.
Thank you.
Heather, if you are the mole and you screwed me over here day one, I'm gonna be pissed.